Well, with all this crazy going on, we haven't got much accomplished. Still don't have my golf cart put together. Got a bunch of junk in the garage. I think it's gonna rain today, so I'm probably gonna be in the garage, which is a good thing, because that's where I really need to start. Is I got the golf cart top and stuff out to clean off, and then it rained for like 3 days in a row, so I didn't get anything done. So now it's just sitting outside. At least it's out of the garage floor. We still got all this over here, right? Those two logs or stumps over there are pretty good sized, and they're pretty good. They're new. They're newer logs that came off of that good stuff, like on the far end. Then we have that giant pecan piece right there. Might still be good on the inside. And then, of course, I have the two cedar posts. So these are two cedar logs my son brought back from that job he was working on. And I think I can get one 2x6 out of each one, plus maybe a couple little, one, you know, above and below, little 1x's or something. But really all I need is the 2x6. Out of a 10-foot section, I can make one full cross. Well, actually, I can almost make, if out of both of them, I can probably make three crosses of those big 4-foot crosses that I make. And that's kind of what I'm going for. So if I can get that out of there, because those are $20 each for those, you know, 2x6 rough cut cedar. So if I can get that out of here, that'll be great. Plus, it'll be good logs to try on the first thing on the sawmill when we get it, because, you know, if I do mess up, oh well, they were free. So anyway, and these pieces right here that my son picked up from that job he did, one of them's just a cedar stump that I might try to take off, mill up with two, and just get two little tables for end tables or something, like a matching set of end tables made out of the stump. And then of course over there we've got that tree that fell a couple years ago, but I know it's a, I think it's a post oak, so it'll be oak for woodworking or whatever. I don't know if it's any good or not, but at least I could get some boards out of it. So what I'm thinking about doing is getting me a sawmill, and I'm going to put it right in front of that as our work area. Got the log splitter over here, and then we'll have a sawmill right there. So I'm kind of looking at the Woodland Mills 126. I don't know, I just like that one. It seems just little things. There's like a little, even a little scraper that when the rollers go, it keeps a little spring with a wire that keeps the groove from getting sawdust in it, so that it rolls smooth. So I like that idea. But pretty much that's all we're going to be doing this weekend, is working. I'm going to try to get some of this picked up a little bit real quick, so that I can get it on the trailer. We did finish the floor on the trailer from my mom. Brought that down here with the toolbox and got her stuff moved out. That floor was rotten. I mean, I think I showed you a picture of it last weekend, but that floor, you couldn't walk on it. We had a, Philip had put a big full sheet of plywood on it just to be able to haul the stuff back, because some of the boards were just completely through. I don't think the guy used treated lumber, and he only sprayed like a light coat of black paint on it. It's probably why it rotted out like that. But now we've got some good treated boards on there. We will, once it stops raining, get some water seal on there or something to make them last just a little bit longer. That's it. But yeah, we're gonna go into the shop and start cleaning. Well, I'm glad I got my video done. And now I'm in the garage, so I guess I can just work on my cleaning my bench off. Well, I'm making some progress. I got this little area almost cleaned up, and then I can move this motor off of here. Not sure where I'm gonna put it yet, but it's one thing you love about Texas is it rained really hard this morning. You know, I just showed you a picture of that or whatever, and now my wife's out mowing the grass and I'm in here cleaning up, got my doors open. I was out working on the lawnmowers a little bit. Phil's finishing up the gate, and you know, don't even know it rained. So anyway, most of this is just crap over the years from using this vise to cut and grind and just things we needed to on the vise here. And rather than cleaning up after each use, and then a lot of this was Phil was working on some little bitty old chainsaw that somebody gave him. And we also have changed out the bearings here a couple times with the vise. And I'm saving these because I'm going to use them for the little balls. I'm going to use them for heads on little crafts and make a little butterfly and a few other little things out of them, caterpillar and some stuff. So I'm saving all the bearings, but the rest of this is just old rusted bolts that we've cut off, and
heads of things and filings and everything else. So I've got most of the plastic picked up, I think. But easy way, they actually sell these kind with just a little lever. But you know, you get all these filings all over. So this is just how I clean them up. Gets all the metal and everything, all these filings, and then you just pull your paper off. There you go. And it picks everything up. You don't have to worry about it cleaning off your magnet, because your magnet gets nasty with all those on there. You know, it's like, especially if I run it right here, all that would be on your magnet. But instead, you just take the paper off. There you go. And you just keep doing that until you get most of it cleaned up. Then I'll get the shop vac over here. Really just getting the big pieces, and then I'll clean this off with the shop vac. And then I can move to that half, which is actually pretty clean, even though it doesn't look like it. I've just got some, I was making some crosses and stuff over there. So most of that's just paint and stain and some stuff like that. I gotta move that saw off and put that back up on the shelves and stuff. And then that side will be pretty much clean again, and I'll be left with mainly the motor in the middle. But I'll probably just take him off of this board, move him over here, and then we'll go from there. But my goal was to get this cleaned off today, and I've still got, I don't know, I got a few hours left. It's 3 o'clock, so I got plenty of time. So this will be one thing off of my list, and it's a big thing. The other thing I did was I got the toolbox that I got put back together and got it stacked up. I got the side piece out there washing. It's drying out there, right? You can see it behind the golf cart. It's out there drying up. I just sprayed it off because it had some mud dauber nests in it and stuff. And I'll probably move my saws and circular saws and stuff in there. And I think I'm gonna clean out this corner tonight. I'll start a fire and burn some of that trash wood there that's just cut off from, I think it was the JP2 sign that we made. So cut that off, get that cleaned up, get the electrolysis bin cleaned up. I don't have any pans or anything to do. So I might as well just take that up and use that tub for someone else, or maybe I'll just put it up there. That way, if I ever do want to use it again, it's available and ready to go. So that might be what I do. And I am going to get some, see, I'm talking about it and I'm adding to the list. Like I said, there's never done. I think before I do that, I'm going to go get some insulation and 3 pieces of the OSB and finish that wall. And then I can put that toolbox right against that wall in that corner, and it'll be a nice place to put it out of the way. All right, well, I made some pretty good progress. I still got a little decisions to make of where I'm gonna put stuff, like this radio. I need to figure out where to put it. I still use the one in the shop here, so my idea was to use that one down at the garden, but I don't have a shed down there yet to put it into. So I need to build some kind of enclosure for it, and then it'll work fine, and I'll probably just put it down there. I found these things. I bought these, I don't know, a year and a half ago. I guess they were over here underneath crap. And this is for a, so I got the idea from a portable display that we had at the Wounded Warrior there, at Air Force Wounded Warrior. And they use it, and it's basically just a PVC stand. So here's your legs with your legs coming out, a piece of PVC like this, right? And then you got this rectangle up here, and then you got these all legs. You can envision it right here. Just put pieces of PVC in between it, right? And then it's this stretchy type material. And I was going to make a projector screen out of it, and you just pull the stretchy white material over the top, and you've got you an outdoor portable break, and it breaks down because you don't glue it. So you just break it all down, put it in a bag, and there you go. You've got your portable projector. So I'll make that one of these days. As always with any projects in the list, As I've said many times, it just grows and grows. I've got all these cans of things over here, but I have no more shelf space over there. I guess we've purchased, you know, cans of stain and paint and whatever over the time, and I just don't have any space left over there. So tomorrow, I'm going to have to make some more shelves in order to finish cleaning this off. Bounce some stuff for the crafts. I just put all them in this box here because I've got a few projects, tent stakes and some more candle holders and some stuff that I'm going to make. So I found those, put them in there. This is just a box of crap. I don't even know what I'm going to do with it. So, but just a little bit of decisions to make, and then some shelves to make, and then I'll have this pretty much done. So I almost made it, but by the end of the weekend, I should have it done. So So, as always, get outside, do something. We'll catch you in the next video, and thanks for watching. Have a great week. And if you're really bored during this isolation, make you one of those, get you one of those cheap $99 Amazon projectors, and there you go, outdoor projector for the family.